is made possible by grants from the Dun & Bradstreet Corporation, Merrill Lynch Pierce Fenner & Smith Incorporated, Arthur D. Little Incorporated, Charles E. Culpepper Foundation, the Arthur Vining Davis Foundations, and the William & Mary Grieve Foundation. Enterprise is co-produced with Learning Corporation of America.
I get to go to Japan! I got to go to Japan! I got to get a passport tomorrow? Where? Where do I get a passport?
This woman works for National Semiconductor Corporation in Santa Clara, California. She and three co-workers are being sent on a two-week trip to Japan to visit a toy factory. Their mission? To find out how these Japanese workers and managers keep productivity so high. This week on Enterprise, West meets East.
I'm Eric Severide. The stunning success of Japanese business in recent years has wounded our national pride. Japan is outperforming us in a long line of industries, from televisions and automobiles to shipping and steel. And adding irony to injury, Japan's productivity came out of a conscious effort to copy our manufacturing techniques. But while they improved upon them, we did not. Now it's we who hope to copy them. Questions about Japanese business abound. How do their managers motivate the workers? How do they structure the work process to make it more efficient? And how much of a part does their culture play in their success? This week on Enterprise, we follow four employees of a high-tech company as they try to discover firsthand what makes Japan run.
Charles Spork is the president of National Semiconductor, one of the country's most successful makers of circuit chips. Annual sales, more than $1 billion. Recently, Spork's company went into the red for the first time in its 15-year history. One reason? Stiff competition from the Japanese. But now Charlie Spork is ready to fight back.
We're at war with the Japanese, not with bullets, but an economic war. The battleground in the 80s will be in semiconductors, or integrated circuits, as we call them, and computers.
Hi, Charlie.
Down, folks.
Barry.
Supposed to sit down? Oh, usually I kneel.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Hi. Charlie,
okay. I've got a surprise for you people.
Oh, dear.
You're all fired.
Sorry, Charlie.
Well, it's possible.
Yes, I know.
I think probably all of you are aware of the fact that U.S. industry has a problem based upon the attack of the Japanese, and that means that they're involved in attacking our company, National Semiconductor. We've come up with a unique approach to help us meet the challenge, and that is that we want to send all four of you to Japan.
You're right, that's me.
And the reason we want you to go to Japan, we want you to observe what's going on over there. You're a pretty good cross-section of our company. An engineer, assembly line operator, production manager, and assistant manager. You'll go through a Japanese company. National Semiconductor specifically wants to meet the challenge. We want to win.
That's very good.
It's fun to win.
Oh,
mining's
yeah.
A good idea.
The
super idea, Charlie. It really is. I think we can come back with a lot of good information.
I would think so, too. I'm going to bank on you.
Okay, that's a deal. I'm gratified.
Thank
you.
Very excited.
Great.
Very much.
Good show.
We'll see you.
Thank you.
I'll take care of
it. In early May, the national contingent arrives in Tokyo, accompanied by a film crew arranged for by National Semiconductor.
Howdy, everybody. How you doing? I'm Randy Davis. Hi, Glenn. You must be Clover?
Yeah.
No, I'm Clover. Howdy, honey. Nice to meet you. You, Gary?
Right.
Hi, I'm Randy Davis.
How you doing, Randy?
I'll be working with you guys while you're over here and translating and helping you get out of the airport and over to the bus.
How do you do?
Oh.
They still bow. I noticed the taxicab guy bowed and the other guy bowed. They still do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed that there. The guy gets out of the trunk, out of the car, and he bowed, and then the porter put his bags in there. He bowed.
Did he say anything at all?
No, just bowed. That was it.
To an American, downtown Tokyo looks a lot like a well-scrubbed version of Times Square. The National Group spends its first evening playing tourist. The group may feel at home here, but beneath the surface there's a social structure quite foreign to Westerners, one well suited to modern industry. The group will spend most of its two-week stay here at Bandai Industries, 80 miles north of Tokyo in an area known as Toy City. With its high productivity, Bandai is the quintessential small Japanese electronics firm. At 7:30 in the morning, Bandai's 300 workers begin their compulsory exercise session. Communication between workers and managers continues non-stop here throughout the day. At morning roll call, the daily quota is first announced and then posted.
Yesterday, we didn't make our target because some people were missing and we had replacements. But today, everyone's present. We will make our target of 800 pieces. Let's go to work.
As in most Japanese companies, these workers are divided into small work sections. All have well-defined tasks, but share overall responsibility for the production of the whole group. Everything is done out in the open, and every worker is under peer pressure to perform well.
Every one of those leads has to be hand-soldered. It's like a microprocessor. Every stage is its own inspection station, and that is, you know, when they pick up the stuff, you know, and they pick up the parts to put in, they first examine it very carefully and make sure that it's a good part to start with before they even start the assemble process.
Members of each section attend frequent quality circle meetings. Sharing information is company policy, and communication goes both ways.
The problem, as you can see, is mostly in the soldering of the IC chip. Most of the bad parts are here, about 40%, and here, 20%. This causes failures with solder bridges at the corners. I've been testing this new piece in soldering. It prevents bending, so I think it's very useful. Maybe we should all use it. That's a good idea. While I'm working, the flux starts sticking to my fingers and sticks to everything I touch. Let me say, from my experience, the best temperature for the iron is 150 degrees. I checked recently, and the temperature was 180 degrees. Working together, we can all solve these problems.
You're a quality assurance worker here, aren't you?
Yes.
Okay, what do you look for in your work here?
I'm checking for sound defects on these toys. Some of the ICs aren't soldered properly.
I have the very distinct feeling that quality is a very, very important thing.
It's extremely important.
Is it quality more important than, say, production?
Yes, production's important too, but quality is more important than quantity.
If you put together a whole bunch of bad parts, how does that affect you inside?
Oh, I feel very sorry. Ashamed. I'm determined not to let it happen again.
The quality of Japanese engineering goes hand in hand with the public's love affair with electronics. It has produced one of the world's most unusual shopping centers, Akihabara, a nine-block area of Tokyo filled with electronic gadgets.
ICs, clock readouts.
National, right
there. Are you kidding?
National.
Hey,
National.
Dad is TI.
Yeah.
1121.
Gotcha.
Who are your primary customers? Who buys these things from you?
Amateur hobbyist.
I designed that part. Brand, how much is this?
It's $1,400. It's about $9.
$9?
Yes.
So you're selling it in the wrong marketplace.
If there's going to be a war between American and Japanese semiconductor makers, who do you think will win? That's a difficult answer, but I think Japan will take it.
Will they win on price or quality?
High quality.
High quality. And the price has also gone way down lately. Why? The Japanese work real hard. The Japanese really, really put in a lot of effort.
Could you tell them for me that we're going to have a lot better prices and a lot better quality, and it's going to be a good fight? This place is unbelievable. If you took all the schlock electronic places in all of the Bay Area, you put them together, you wouldn't get one of these things. The sophisticated stuff. I mean, there's stuff in there that
30 megacycles.
You wouldn't know what to do with, and they're taking it home and playing with it. And if you take that and you say, my God, if they're doing it at that level, well, what are they doing up here? And it's, you kind of get the feeling that they're into it.
In Japan's electronic free-for-all, companies must constantly come up with new products to stay competitive. The Japanese are famous for turning familiar technology into ingenious miniaturized inventions. Much of the work in Japanese industry is done by temporary workers who are outside the national system of permanent employment. In fact, only about a third of Japanese employees hold lifetime jobs. To maintain a flexible workforce, companies tap a large temporary labor pool consisting mainly of women. Most permanent positions go to men.
How long have you worked for this company?
I've been in this company for 15 years.
Would you ever think of trying another job?
No, I'm not even thinking of that. Japanese never think of changing their job. That's our Japanese tradition.
What if you had to make a choice between your job and your family? What would you do?
Of course, I would choose the company. I would take my work any day.
I don't believe what I'm hearing. I myself, my family comes first, then my job.
Don't misunderstand. Like you, we want our family to be happy. But the Japanese is much more loyal to the company. Perhaps because the company strives to make the workers feel a part of the company.
So you would have two families, or one?
Yes.
Yes, you can say that. I understand. I have two families. I am a child of this company. When I go back to my family, I am a father. The notion of corporate family is taken very seriously here, sometimes all the way to the altar.
Companies are totally involved in their permanent employees' lives and grant benefits ranging from housing to honeymoons. Today, these two fine workers of our company are getting married. From the bottom of my heart, I wish them happiness. Utsuo-san is a secretary and will continue working for us after marriage. She is a good, conscientious worker. She is also intelligent and very beautiful. Sano-san is a very dedicated worker. He contributes excellently to the maintenance of quality, which is the chief goal of our company. He has a strong will and a sincere attitude. Their sensitivity to others and their cooperative attitude will serve them well in their marriage, as it has in their work.
This is fly. Incredible. What a piece of engineering. Ohashi-san, who designed this? You?
Of course.
Engineering marvel. Absolutely an engineering marvel. I gotta have one.
Bandai regularly courts groups of school children at its toy showroom. Its executives like to think of these children, not just retailers and wholesalers, as their ultimate customers. The sentiment is reflected in Bandai's company pledge, recited daily.
For the customer, satisfaction provided by team effort. For our customers, hard work, which alone will ensure our future. For our customers, creativity in everything we do. Thank you. Good morning. As you know, we are experiencing economic difficulties. This past quarter, business has slipped badly. To survive this harsh environment, we have to be innovative. We have to develop new markets. We have to develop new products. Most of all, we have to emphasize the customer. Think about the customer first and foremost. Orders are difficult to get, so we really have to cherish them. Work accurately and precisely for the customer. That is the only way of survival.
The most significant thing to me was he related to the people on the line about the customer. We don't tell our people in the line about the customer. We don't tell them ever. The girls don't even know who the hell a customer is. And he stressed that many, many times. Major point.
Every little job in the whole plant affects the customer.
I think it's important that the people on the line see the big boss there talking to them. We don't have that. And here's a guy that's above a plant manager down here telling it like it is. Very impressive.
These employees have a financial stake in teamwork. As in much of Japanese industry, workers here receive a large share of their salary in the form of bonuses linked to annual profits. And when this freshman class of new employees is trained, the group is stressed above all.
You've been part of our company for only a month. You're young and inexperienced, so we're not expecting you to become experts right away. Just remember, as toy makers, we have to think of the children who are the soul of this nation. We're not just making toys, we're affecting the future of Japan. So don't regard your work as just a job. It's a part of children's dreams. Shall we go on? I think the company's stuck in a rut, doing the same thing over and over, and a lot needs to be improved. For example, in my section, we test every battery of the electronic game, but the batteries nowadays are so good, and they last so long, it's not necessary to test every one. maybe we should just take a few samples for testing. That's good thinking. It's important that everyone think like that. Every time an idea comes to you, let me know. Never think I'm unaware of you or neglecting you. I remember each of you. I will remember each of you. We have problems, many problems. You will discover them as you're working.
At Bandai, it's not just the work of the employees that is carefully managed, but their attitude as well. By the end of the day, the group has surpassed its quota.
What's your general impression of, say, American technology?
Well, I think American technology is more advanced. Americans are far more creative than Japanese. Japanese are very good at taking something that exists and improving it, running with it. But we're not good at creating something from nothing.
Do you think Japanese ICs are better than American ICs?
Yes, absolutely. It's strange, you know, because we learned quality from America. In the past, American quality was much higher than Japan's. So we determined to catch up with you. And we not only caught up, we surpassed you.
After work, Clover and Randy are invited for a farewell dinner at the home of Mrs. Suwara, Clover's counterpart in quality control.
I like the way they hurry back to their jobs. That's very nice. Also impressed with your morning calisthenics. I thought that was quite nice.
Don't you do that in America?
No.
You just go straight into work in the morning? Mm-hmm.
Straight right into work. That way, the way you do it, everybody sort of loosens up and...
Do you do, for example, a speech by the president of the company or director or something in the morning? Address in the morning?
Not in the morning, no. Once a month, maybe, something like that. Do you need the speech to motivate you? Or is it just you feel comfortable that the president cares about you?
At such a meeting, all of us understand what we're going to be working for, what we're going to be doing in the future, and I think it's necessary to know that.
The men say goodbye at a small party that evening. For these Japanese managers, after-hours socializing is part of the job.
Is he aware of the fierce competition economically between Japan and America?
Yes, I understand. I'm aware of it.
Does he think that Japan will win that economic war? Yes.
I believe consumers will decide who will win that type of war. They will decide on what is the better product for the better price.
The party ends with the Bandai cheer.
Spent 2 weeks over here, and I think there's a certain percentage of what I've seen and what I've learned that could be applied to American industry and could make it better.
It just seems to me if some of these things that we take back can be discussed with our product line managers and say, hey, this is what I saw. Can it apply to us in some way at all?
They're very clever, these people. They involve the people in a very family sense of the word, that they're part of a larger, greater Bandai. And we don't do any of that.
They're on that line, and they don't need anybody cracking a whip over them. They do it on their own. They do it on their own because, just like you do things for your family on your own, nobody has to come and tell you, Glenn Miller.
But you can't very well say that because it's their family. We can't go back and tell the American people, everybody that works for General Motors or National, they're your family now. I really
No, I'm not saying that. You're missing my points. That is that management obviously takes a much higher interest in the everyday employee than what American companies tend to do. They're much more involved. They go to the weddings. They even throw the weddings. It is something that I think American industry could do very easily.
There's nothing magic going on here. All these people are doing is doing what we're capable of doing in the first place, what we used to do a long time ago, somewhere along before we lost the thread of the idea. Do you agree?
Well, yeah, because I'm going to start telling the people how they're doing overall. What is our yields running? Yeah. Where we don't do this. We really don't.
I'm going to go back and do it.
I'm going to buy me an American flag that's 48 feet square and wave that son of a bitch to anybody that wants to see it and let them know that, hey, we got the greatest place in the world, and all we got to do is have a little bit of initiative on our own, not worry about somebody's going to shortchange them. Everybody says it's somebody else's job. And I guess what it boils down to, it's my job. All I had was noodles without any sauce on it. Raw fish.
Clean your area.
Next, Say Brother takes us through rehearsals and a performance of Godspell and investigates Boston's Black United Fund.
I mean, Hi-Fi television sets, but most important of all, a million components laying out like chopped liver. They meet with the plant manager every month.
They're shy to come over. It's all right.
This program was presented by WGBH-TV, which is solely responsible for its content, and was made possible by grants from the Dun & Bradstreet Corporation, Merrill Lynch Pierce Fenner & Smith Incorporated, Arthur D. Little Incorporated, Charles E. Culpepper Foundation, the Arthur Vining Davis Foundations, and the William & Mary Grieve Foundation. Enterprise is co-produced with Learning Corporation of America.